We want to find the average rate of change of the function f of x equals negative x squared plus 9 divided by x on the closed interval from 1 to 6. To find the average rate of change of a function, we want to find the change in the output, or change in the function values, and then divide by the change in input, which is the change in the x values. Notice how determining the average rate of change is the same as determining the slope between two points. So for the first step, we want to determine the function values when x equals 1 and x equals 6. So f of 1 is going to be equal to negative 1 squared plus 9 divided by 1. This will be negative 1 plus 9, which is equal to 8. So f of 1 is equal to 8, which means the input is 1 and the output is 8. This also represents a point on the graph where the x coordinate would be 1 and the y coordinate would be 8. Now we need to find f of 6. So we would have negative, or the opposite of 6 squared, plus 9 divided by 6. Well, this would be negative 36, which I'll write as negative 36 over 1, plus 9, 6 simplifies to 3 halves. So to add these, our common denominator is going to be 2. So we're going to multiply this fraction by 2 over 2. So the denominator is going to be 2. The numerator is going to be, this will be negative 72 plus 3, which is negative 69. Here, our input is 6, and the output is negative 69 halves. Which again, if we want to, we could write as an ordered pair, where the x coordinate would be 6, and the y coordinate would be negative 69 divided by 2. Now we have all the information we need to determine the average rate of change on this interval. We'll first determine the change in the outputs, or the change in the function values. So we'd have negative 69 halves minus 8, which I'm going to write as 8 over 1. Again, notice how this is the difference in the function values, or if we want, the difference in the y coordinates. And we'll divide this by the change in the inputs, or the change in the x values, which would be 6 minus 1. Or again, if we wanted to, we could use the x coordinates from the points. Now we need to simplify this. Looking at the numerator, we have to have a common denominator, which would be 2. So multiply this fraction by 2 over 2. So we're going to have a denominator of 2. We'll have negative 69 minus, this will be 16. That's going to be negative 85. And then 6 minus 1 is equal to 5. Let's go ahead and write this as negative 85 halves. Then instead of dividing by 5, let's multiply by the reciprocal. So we're going to multiply by 1/5. In this form, we can see 5 and negative 85 simplifies. There's 1 5 in 5 and negative 17 5s in 85. So we can see our rate of change is going to be negative 17 halves. So the average rate of change of f of x on the interval from 1 to 6 is negative 17 halves. To interpret this, remember the negative 17 represents the change in the output, or change in function values, and the 2 represents the change in the input, or change in x values. So on average, on this interval, the function value will decrease 17 every time the input increases 2. And as I mentioned earlier, this average rate of change would be the same as the slope between these two points. So let's finish by taking a look at this graphically. Here's the graph of our function. Here's the point when x equals 1, and here's the point when x equals 6. The slope of this red line is equal to the average rate of change, which we just found as negative 17 halves. I hope you found this example helpful.